Growing up, did a lot of dancing and I played a lot of music as well. It's not until recently that I realized how musical the paintings actually are. I've always thought I can feel rhythms. I think that's really come out in the paintings themselves. There is this sort of underlying rhythm to the gestures and the composition of the whole painting. With a lot of music I listen to, I can hear a lot of different parts in it and the way all those parts weave together to form an atmosphere. And I think that I approach painting the same way. Like every plane of colour and every gesture and every even colour choice in the palette is being added in a unique mix that I feel like I'm always trying to surprise myself with. And I'm trying to paint something I haven't seen before and push that harmonic mix as far as I can and create something quite different. There's some very bright tones in this body of work juxtaposed against more somber browns and deep greens. There are some moments in these works which have smaller detail, and that's, I guess, I'm trying to push the contrast between the scale of gestures within the work. When you have a small gesture in one part, it brings your eye right in. You see it almost as a small space that's far away from you, and then against that, you've got the bigger paintbrush marks and things, which then suddenly look a whole lot bigger. You kind of see the whole narrative playing out on the canvas in almost a circular way. I like to have one almost excessively large work. You read it from left to right, and I kind of wanted this to have a narrative. It's all part of creating this tension and release in the painting. The work starts with the dark side, which feels very night-like. I think overall it feels like I'm going from night to day. There's a few areas which are deliberately more minimal, where there's only a few gestures that kind of enter into that space, and then others where it's got some transparent lilac. I've been quite obsessed with that colour, particularly for this show, so it appears in a few of the works. I've been recently really trying to push atmosphere. They are gestural abstraction and they belong to that lineage, but at the same time, how can I evoke an atmosphere that's of something else and make you think of both things at one time? The bordering in View for the Brave is really important to me, as some paintings have this kind of bordering around them by one particular colour. Painting in centre creeps out into that border at different places, so it's not completely bordered, but generally it's kind of this construction. And I guess you see that in the fresco ceiling sometimes, is this circular composition. Each painting evolves from the previous one, so certain bodies of work have an atmosphere as an overall, but they all kind of flow together in one big thread. There's a brightness of colour for it, and I think with this particular body of work, they are all very much unique individual paintings. And yet, in a way, it's like when you play a note on a piano and then you play a different note or you play a different chord, the colour of them or the way that sounds is, it could be really high and bright or low and moody. So each painting feels like a different note.